This I found out about through Insider Carpentry. If you haven't checked out Insider Carpentry on YouTube or Instagram, his name's Spencer, amazing Finnish carpenter. He was using this in one of his videos. I'll put a link to his channel at the top of the description. But I asked him what it was and he told me it's a Franklin Sensors Pro Stud Finder. So I was really interested. I went ahead and ordered one on Amazon and I just put it under the tree to make myself feel like an early Christmas. So I'm gonna open it right now and talk about it and we'll see how this compares to my zircon that I've been using for years. So let's check this thing out. All right, so we're gonna kind of compare these two stud finders. This is my Old Faithful right here. This is my zircon edge finding and I really like the edge finding and I'll tell you why in a minute. But this is my son and daughter's room and we're gonna try it in here because we're going to be putting some really neat wainscot in here. And anytime we're gonna lay out for wainscot, we're always finding the studs because we wanna shoot our units of wainscot panels that we pocket hole together, we wanna shoot them into the stud. So what I'll do, I know there's gonna be a stud around here, around this outlet, and I know there's gonna be one on this corner. So what I like to do to kind of visualize it is I'll just put my stud finder on the wall and then slide it over. And with the edge finding, it's gonna detect the edge of the stud. So it should be coming up soon, right there. And then I'll mark that right there. And then I like to come from the other side and then mark the other side as well. So now I know I've got a stud right there and that box right there is nailed into it. So that's always a good indication of where they're gonna be. And that's 1.5 inches. So we know we've got one there. And the reason I like the edge finding is because I can visually see it. It just works with my brain better. I can see it rather than using a center finding one. They tend to, at least for me, the zircon that I had, it tend to have like a lot of mist detects. Like I would go to like screw something in and there'd be like nothing, just drywall punching through. So that's why I like this. I can visually see it. And it's kind of a double check. Because if you got one and you got the other one, you know there's one there. So that's that one. I have no complaints about it. It's always pretty good for me. It gets the job done. Now with the new one that I just purchased, that I just found out about, we're gonna open this up and see how it compares to this one, because I think it'd be pretty interesting. And I'm really curious to see how this thing works because it has 13 sensors. This thing seems pretty serious. High accuracy, finds wood and metal, deep scan always on. It can scan and detect up to a little over 1.5 inches of, I guess, drywall. That's pretty amazing. So if you had layers of drywall on top of each other, like in a remodel or an old home, it says it'll detect up to over 1.5 inches, 13 sensors, 7-inch wide LED display. So let's freaking open this thing up. I'm excited to see how it's gonna work. I think it's pretty self-explanatory. We're just gonna pop some batteries in it and see how it works out. So here's the unit, popped it open. And first impression of it is pretty lightweight. It has a ruler up here from 1 to 7 inches. So that's pretty convenient. You can see if you find a stud and you can know like how wide it is. Like I just told you guys, this was 1.5 inches wide. You'll be able to see that accurately and just know, boom, there's a stud right there. So I got the batteries. We'll pop this thing open and see how it operates. 2 AA batteries. There's the 13 sensors right here. So we'll go ahead and give this thing a shot. And we'll test it up against our zircon right here to get started. And just slide it over and it should light up as it detects. So it's detecting a stud right there. There, it picked up on the zircon. It was a little late actually in the beginning. Let's see what we got on this try. Okay, so what it's doing is you need to have this whole unit over the stud so you can see it accurately. And you can see those LEDs just follow the stud wherever you move it. And then we've got 1 inch. So we got about 1 inch to there and then that would be 1/2. So yeah, this is showing with these lights and the markings right there on the ruler, it's showing 1.5 inches of stud right there. So that's pretty interesting. Look how that those lights kind of just hover over that stud even as I'm moving this thing back and forth. So let's go on down the wall here and see where our next stud is. All right, showing one right there. And this is kind of it's probably about 16 inches away. That's probably about right. And we'll keep going on down here. There, it picked one up. So there's a wider piece of lumber here. So I'm gonna mark this, because this is interesting, just about where those lights end. And I'm gonna see if my zircon picks up that space right there too. Nice. So zircon is saying right there. And it's saying right there. So both of these things, as you can see, they detect very well. This is just regular drywall with texture on it and paint. So the sensors are great on this, and I'm not complaining about this, but from the looks of this thing looks awesome. It just, you can see it more, like, and it's quick. You just hover it over and you can see the whole picture. So you'd keep going this way and you see the whole picture here. So this thing is awesome. And what I'm curious to see with this thing, because with a lot of other stud finders, if you engage the detect button before you put it on the wall, it'll just act all sorts of crazy, give you some weird readings. So what you're supposed to do is put the device on the wall, engage the button, and then slide it, which you can see that's how this one works too. It's picking up that stud again. So what I'm gonna try right now is just pushing the button before I put it on the wall and seeing what it does. So it's telling me to go this way. No, it seems to have no problem with that. Those 13 sensors that it has are super accurate. So I'll try it right here again. It's picking that one up already. Seems to be pretty precise. It has kind of like this, almost feels like a nice strip of plastic right there, just to not scuff the wall, and it slides across the wall better rather than that felt. That felt tends to have some resistance to it that's on these styles right here. It's got like that felt fabric or whatever it is. But again, it's not a big issue. And let me show you what I was talking about. So if I push this right here before I place it on the wall, it's already confused. And a lot of people, you know, that don't know you need to put this on the wall first and then push the button. So once you do that, it's perfect. You can see it's lined up right there good. But it's just one less thing to think about. So you could just hold the button down and just slide this thing across. Boom, you know, shoot that. Boom, shoot that. And just keep going on down the line versus this thing, just remembering like, all right, put it on the wall, push the button, come over, take it off the wall, let go of the button, push the button, come back over. It's just hold the button down and just fly. So that's a big one up this thing has on this one. So I bet you guys know which one I'm pretty much gonna be using from now on. I like having multiple tools just to always verify things, but this is the new stud finder we're gonna be using for sure. I'm really happy I found this thing and saw Insider Carpentry using it. And it's just an amazing stud finder. I'll put the links for these things in the description if you want to check out this one. This one is really good still, but I'm going to probably start using this one on the job site, especially if you're trying to find like ceiling joists or something. If you're laying out beams, you just slide this thing over. You can see everything and just mark both sides. And center, like I mentioned earlier, center finding is just not my thing. I just may have got a bad unit on my center finding stud finder because I hated that thing. It had so many misdetects, and I would be shooting like a wainscot panel into the wall and there's nothing there. It's just my panel is just going back and forth in drywall. So check these things out. Like I said, if you're interested, I'll put a link in the description and let me know which one you'd rather have or what stud finders you guys like. This isn't a sponsored video. I have never spoken to these companies. This is just me being a tool addict and trying to figure this stuff out and see which one I like better. So I think we're gonna end it there. Next video, we are going this weekend to get our casing for these doors. Probably gonna start running some base, get the handrail stuff done. So let me know if you have any questions or comments in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Take care.